I have read over 500 comments to get to know why do you love evolution simulations. I found most of the comments can fit into three categories. Also, they are the perfect excuse to show you the new features I added to Alien Plants. Oh, by the way, this is Alien Plants. It's my own evolution simulation of a plant ecosystem.
Before I tell you about the three types of comments, I want to share my own experience when I watch other evolution simulation videos. Most of the time, I feel like watching ducks swimming in a pond. I just stare at them, but I want to know more things about how they behave and their dynamics. Here, I'm just watching a system at rest, and that provides limited information. We are just waiting for something to happen. And what would be more interesting than just watching the ducks? I could throw some food at them. I have some bread here. But I could also throw these sticks and see what happens. So if I throw the food, actually, they don't like it. I wasn't expecting that. And it helps me understand the dynamics of the system. But when I throw the sticks, they appear more interested in the sticks than the food. That's something new I wouldn't know just by watching at them. Now I have questions, I have an hypothesis, but I'm not a duck expert. It could be much easier if I had a futuristic scanner that gives me information and stats about the ducks in real time. This is exactly what I want to do with Alien Plants.
And this is when I saw a connection between the three types of comments and my latest additions to Alien Plants.
The first type of comment is the most common, the what if comments. There are a lot of ideas suggested, ideas of things to add, to try, new scenarios, things that would change the system. I see. You want to throw food and sticks to the ducks. I already had a tool to place new seeds, but sometimes I want to get rid of plants that are not doing what I want. So I take out my axe and... ah, that's better. Now I can force the plants to evolve into a specific color, cutting all the colors that I don't want. Now, let's say I want to create a specific type of plant. I can place them, I can cut them, but I'm working with very limited information. This leads me to the second type of comment, the developer comments. Because I'm a developer, I can stop the game and watch inside the guts of the simulation. But you can't, so you start wondering about making your own, asking about details and technical information. I get it, you want to be in full control of the simulation and have access to all the data. It's difficult to understand what's going on exactly in a simulation evolution unless you read all the code. I think the missing information is what influences a lot of the developer comments. So I have started creating more graphs and stats. Now I can approach a plant and see the internal energy and some other values like the height and the mutability. Now I can check very quickly if a plant is going to survive or it will die. I also like that there are some people that can use this information much better than I can. But I'm getting ahead of the unexpected fourth type of comment. The third type of comment is the wholesome comment. People enjoying the video saying things like, "I love that thing that happened," asking to see more or just commenting to support the video. Sometimes it's people new to evolution who say things like,
"This is the best example of evolution I've ever seen."
And for these people, I realize the simulation has to be entertaining too. Because just going to watch the ducks is fun as well. So I added different types of soil, which will hold different amount of nutrients. And I added leaves to add more variety until the new plant model is complete. And there will be more new things to come. These are the three types of comments. But I said there is a fourth one, which I call the expert comment. It's usually someone that has knowledge in a related field, and they are sharing an observation, not an idea or suggestion. They analyze the results in a way that even the creator of the video couldn't.
I love all these type of comments because they all contribute something valuable. And if you're already thinking about all the possibilities of this project, watch this video next, where I explain why a DNA-based model is the only possible future for alien plants.